skiing when I was 2 years old because my family had a vacation home in New Hampshire. So I knew kind of, you know, right then and there that I just loved to ski, and my parents really saw that. I was at a point with my skiing where my parents wanted me to either kind of choose a side, whether it be moguls or downhill skiing. And slopestyle was this new thing, and I was just so intrigued by the creativity of it and the ability that it was, like, this whole aspect that it was so new and that you had, like, total freedom with it. And I mean, at that point, I never thought it would be at the Olympic level. So it's been, you know, awesome to be through this whole progression of slopestyle skiing and really see it, you know, go from first, you know, just having these local events to then having opens and then nationals and junior Olympics and now World Cup circuit and the Olympics. And that's really an honor in itself. It was always in the back of my head that I was born in Paraguay, and when my coaches and I would talk about what the Olympics meant to me, what I really thought about, and that's about where you're from. I began to research Paraguay at a Winter Olympics, and nothing was coming up, and I was completely astonished that, you know, maybe I thought they'd have a figure skater or something like that, and I was just in awe of this idea that I could be the first Olympian for them and really show their country kind of different side of winter sports. Well, arriving in Sochi was definitely, you know, the most surreal feeling ever. I couldn't believe I was at the Olympics. You instantly get off the plane, everything's Olympic themed, everybody's coming towards you, they have it very well organized, and so it was nice to kind of settle down. Everybody before is so excited and lined up together, and you just see this genuine connection that of respect that everybody has earned a spot here, and that being an Olympian is a huge accomplishment in itself. And it was really just an incredible experience, and to be the first and to be the flag bearer was just absolutely crazy, because you see all these teams of hundreds of people, and then that, like, 45 seconds to a minute and a half walking through the stadium was just incredible. Right now, that's my ultimate goal, to go back. It was an incredible experience, and I would love to have the opportunity to do that again. That was hard for not just myself, but for a lot of athletes, this kind of different schedule where usually these events start in early December and end in April, and they were now starting in December and ending the second week of January. So it was just a crazy kind of different year. And I'd say my favorite aspect of slopestyle skiing is the ability to use your creativity, and that no course is ever the same. It allows for the entire field to kind of succeed, because, like I said, you really don't see the same three girls on the podium, and that's awesome in itself. And there's this special bond kind of between the slopestyle community where everyone's very supportive and only wants the best for their competitors.